I mean, I love it. It's one of the most beautiful places in the world to train.
Boulder attracts some of the best athletes in the country, like Sam Long.
Yep, born and raised here.
Training for an Ironman here is typically gorgeous, but parts of Saturday's 70-mile race happened under a plume of smoke.
To be honest, I didn't really notice it while I was racing, and it was only then after that then I was like, it smells like a campfire out, and kind of noticed it.
Long finished first place in the half Ironman, even breaking a course record as air quality continued to go downhill in the morning.
Just a scratchy throat this morning. Red eyes, but nothing too much. Yes, the faster you went yesterday, the less time you had breathing in the campfire.
It's always nice to get those bragging rights, and I guess Sam got the bragging rights over me yesterday.
Sam Appleton finished second behind Long.
And I didn't really notice the smoke until maybe the last 20 or 30 minutes of our race, but unfortunately, you know, we were on the faster end, and you know, people are out there for a lot longer than us, so I definitely feel for those athletes that were out there, you know, for 5-6 hours.
These incredible professionals may have missed the worst of it, competing so quickly. Denver's air has been pretty awful even before this race. The city recorded 30 straight days with bad air.
It is a little bit unfortunate. When I first came here in 2015, I feel like it definitely wasn't like this. Maybe last year, 2020, and now this year, it's been lingering a little bit.
On race day, it's just better not to think about that stuff.
And the top athletes finished the race in under 4 hours. Others, though, were competing for more than 7, which is right around when the air quality was going way downhill in the afternoon.